7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 18. Good. And the reason I didn't count a landing stride there was because she really split that rail.
Okay.
She didn't step over it, but because you were powerful in your canter, she didn't trot. Hips back. Good. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Land.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Good. And you had the right idea, Peyton, to land and ho, because she got a little excited, didn't she?
Yes.
Yeah, so come do that again. I don't care if it's off the... And I want 4 straight strides, and that will kind of let you know where you're at. Keep the hands a little bit lower. Good. Good. Hips back. Use the leg just a little bit, not to go faster, but to balance her. 1, 2, 3. Whoa. 1, 2, 3. Right, was that an even 4?
No.
No, how many straight strides did you get out of the corner?
3.
Right, so does that tell us, we have a lot of work to do?
Yeah.
Yeah. So see what I mean, how this, just taking, making this one stride shorter makes it a lot harder, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, come off the right. Make her canter right in 4. And listen to me, I'm gonna count out of the corner. And like I said, that's a very, very good indicator as to how this whole thing might work out. It's not always gonna work out that way, but it gives you an idea. That's your canter. Good girl, make it happen. Look. Plan ahead. Whoop, 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 whoop. 1, 2, 3, 4. Good girl. 1, 2, 3, 4. Well done. Coming 4 again. Here, elasticize the canter. Kind of just ease up on her, you know, say good girl, let her canter just a bit. And then start bringing her back. A little more. Bring her back a little more. Whoop, whoop. Outside, 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 outside. 1, 2, 3. Whoop. 1, 2, 3. Right. Come off the right again. So we got 3 out of the corner, right?
Yeah.
And it kind of showed up here because we got 3 and then a little crappy one. And bring her back a little more. Yeah. And insist. And insist we're going to get the 4 again. Stay in your outside rein and your outside stroke. Outside, outside, outside. Whoop, whoop. 1, 2, 3, 4. There. 1, 2, 3, 4. There. Change your lead. And then you're going to come in the 3. But you're not going to have to gun her. Easy, easy. I guarantee you she'll lead up the stride. That moves her up a little bit. Now we want the 3 out of the corner. Outside rein, outside stirrup. 1, 2, 3. Land. 1, 2, 3. Whoop. That's okay. Why did that one happen? Right, you were pretty darn wide in that turn. Okay, so that sort of, you had more distance to travel. Okay?
Yeah, I don't know if it's just me, but I kind of felt like I was looking out, and I was like, oh she turned too fast, so I didn't turn.
Right, right. And I would agree with that. There was just like a miscommunication here. Now, one more time, go ahead through the corner, kind of close the leg. Just okay. Keep saying, come on, come on, come on. So we have a nice positive 3 out of the corner. Would you agree that the 3 out of the corner was a little bit long?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Good. Yeah.
Good. Hips back a little bit and close the leg firmly, strong. That's fine. You actually stayed with it. It was a half. Go on. Was a half distance there out of the corner. You can't lean, it's your jump. Okay? So meaning you can't get too close to the neck. Keep coming. Yes. Look, sooner. 1, 2, 3. Good. 1, 2, 3. There. Beautiful, Peyton. Good girl. Walk and paddle. Balance, balance, balance. Watch the leaning. And walk. There you go. So first of all, out of the corner, it was a little bolder and stronger. okay. And then, and I think you knew it too. As soon as you left the ground here, I think you knew it was going to happen. Because you said something.
The four strides, if I'm bounced up and doing good.
Right.
Do you count? Do you start counting right as right?
It's four straight strides. So there's a bending turn, there's a bending stride, and there's a stride after that that's still not straight, and then you start counting.
Okay.
So I'll try and count out loud for you when you get straight.
Do you feel like I'm hearing it better? Because I feel like I'm hearing
yeah,
it better.
Yeah, you've met many more times, like especially when you were counting in the trot.
Yeah.
I don't know that I heard you count too much in the canter today yet. But when you were counting in the trot, you were much more on the rhythm.
Okay. So come off my left, right first.
Right, five, left, four.
I'm plugging in the circle. So.
Okay. Even there, you're leaning. Come on, stay in that outside stirrup. Stay in that outside seat bone, outside stirrup. Good. Now stay on the outside. Keep your outside rein as well. Inside leg to outside rein. Use your whole turn. One, two, three, four. Whoop. One, two, three, four, five. Good girl. Turn right. Balance. Ride your trot. Then change directions. Up at that end. Balance. Don't just pull on her. Outside stirrup and outside rein. Steady. Left knee canter. And go on. And you're going to get the four.
Oh.
Yep, so go on a little bit. There. Watch the leaning. Go on. Right. Right. Look. Look. Go on. Go on. Go on. Go on. Go on. Land. Whoop. Two, three, four. Good. Balance. Good girl. Track right. Yeah. So don't let her just fall out in the corner. Even if you're done, you finish the exercise. Because then that's a bad transition right there, right? Go ahead and walk. Your exercise is good. We'll talk about that in a second.
Okay.
But always remember to finish your exercise. And horses get unbalanced and strung out through corners, so they're really happy to just talk through a corner. Hands a little bit lower. Good, now balance that. Because the last jump we did was on the four, right? So now we want this to be shorter.
Oh, yeah.
Right, steady. One, two, three. One, two, three, four. There. Okay, so you made it. However, you made it mostly because the first jump was pretty weak, right? Would
yeah.
you agree? Okay, so stay in your outside stirrup and your outside rein. Balance her up. Little shorter step. Look. Both reins steady, steady. One, two, three. Whoop. One, two, three. Yeah? Okay, so remember, walk for a second. Right. So, okay, and I should have probably just reminded and clarified. The four here is equivalent to the five on the straight line, remember? So how many straight strides? When we got the five in the middle, how many straight strides did we have out of the corner?
Four.
Right. Do you know how many straight strides you had this time?
Three.
Right. So that's why you struggled a little bit. And again, you got it partially because she thought she was going straight, and when you turned her, it sort of rattled her a little bit and she could put in another stride. But it really was, that was really more on a pace to get three, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Okay, so go ahead and I'll probably come again. And